Hello, and welcome to the Cryptocurrency News Channel. Got some news for Ripple and XRP, and Ripple has announced their new goal because their original one of getting a bunch of banks to adopt XRP hasn't really worked all that well, or hasn't really worked at all. So David Schwartz, in an interview with Blockdown TV, they want to realize over the next 5 years with these plans, and the big plan is Ripple is going to enter DeFi. One main reason for the drop in XRP price is the stagnation of Ripple's business model. They're pushing the price both due to stagnation in the business model and the occasional XRP sale. Now, they've stopped most of those XRP sales, let me remind you. So the XRP sales really aren't a huge part of it anymore. So David Schwartz stated that Ripple will soon enter DeFi. Now, about a couple of months ago, he actually planned to leave Ripple in about 18 months. I think those plans have been pushed backwards because Ripple's not anywhere near where they actually thought it would be. The dozens of banks by the end of 2019 never really panned out. They still don't have one single bank really using XRP for remittances. So stating that they will go for XRP-based lending or financing the Ripple network in the DeFi sector, the senior manager thinks that this will change RippleNet. Now, this is probably just another play because their original use case wasn't really working all that well, and they want to find a new use case where they can actually get more transactions, get more liquidity, and maybe bring some more people in. Now, I will say that this actually could work, but the issue with this is that Ethereum already has a lot of the DeFi market, and there are other blockchains, all of which are basically superior technically to Ethereum, but none which have actually really made a dent in the Ethereum market share in DeFi. And Ethereum still owns nearly 100% of DeFi. Now, Ripple being the number three cryptocurrency might have more pull than them, but it's still going to be extremely hard to get people to change from Ethereum. I mean, you have all these other mainnets that have tried and are still trying right now, like EOS, Tron, Tezos, ZIL. VET has a couple of DeFi apps, but they're not really concentrating on DeFi that much. Sunny's like, yeah, we'll try it. But they're still more on enterprise blockchain adoption, which they're actually doing real good on. So Ripple will have to get over the Ethereum hurdle. Yes, the transactions per second definitely favor XRP and XRP Ledger. But we've seen, like with other networks that have the tens of thousands or thousands of transactions per second, that they still didn't really attract the users. And I really do think DeFi is somewhat of a bubble. Most of these DeFi projects suck. I mean, and they don't really have a purpose except to make like to basically make interest. And you can't really survive on that. And the thing is, like, most people right now still use DeFi as just kind of a gambling game to make more money. They don't actually use DeFi as a decentralized finance tool, which is going to be, you know, what eventually it should be. But it's probably going to be a couple of years before that happens. So that's why there's a five-year plan. Now, I think for Ripple to move without Bitcoin, it's going to have to be at least 3 to 5 years now because, you know, like the whole thing with them losing a lot of their usage with MoneyGram and stuff a while ago, and it'll take them a while to recover. And then right now the banking adoption is just really not there. So the whole idea with DeFi, I think, actually jives okay with their plan, because if they can actually get this DeFi thing started, it could build the liquidity in the network over the next few years for banks to actually come on, and finally for part of their vision to actually come out. So them entering the DeFi market is like a sideways, like, kind of detour of the original plan, but it goes along with the original plan because the original plan actually didn't work out all that well, or hasn't been working out all that well. The DeFi industry was booming in 2020, and it still is, but like I said, a lot of those things are actually scams, and Ripple's plan is to support it with its own business models. Now, they've been building basically a bridge from, trying to build a bridge from Ripple XRP Ledger to Ethereum. Not really sure if anyone's going to use that, but we'll actually see. Aiming to implement the blockchain-based lending or receiving method for cross-border transactions, Ripple may have found an absolutely important method. If Ripple can motivate more than 300 corporate members in its network in line with its plan to use XRP on the platform, it can be said that this time XRP may be one of the cryptocurrencies that eat the bread of the DeFi industry. I really doubt that. I don't think any corporate entities are really eyeing, like, oh man, we want to use DeFi right now. They probably think like me that DeFi is kind of a scamish thing right now. And they're going to wait a couple of years for it to jump in. They're going to wait until it stabilizes to actually jump in any kind of these big corporate entities. So really, if you want DeFi to move Ripple's market share, at least a year or two, probably 3+ years for this to really affect price. But it is a good market for XRP and Ripple to go into. So that is the news for today. Let me know what you think. Like and subscribe. Hit that bell notifications button. Thank you and have a nice day.